Designing neural networks is difficult and time-consuming, and with the success of models like Inception, ResNets, FractalNets, and DenseNets, it's increasingly clear that there is value in sophisticated, branching architectures. Automated methods can discover good architectures through evolution or reinforcement learning, but require Google levels of compute to work well. I propose an orthogonal approach to exploring the design space with only Andy levels of compute power. Rather than fully training, then evaluating a set of architectures, I use an auxiliary model called a HyperNet that learns to dynamically generate the weights for a wide range of network structures, allowing us to rapidly compare the relative performance of each net at the cost of a single training run. Here's how it works. At every training step, we sample a random network architecture, then feed a description of that architecture to the HyperNet in the form of a one-hot tensor. The HyperNetwork takes that network description and generates the network weights, and the entire thing is trained end-to-end. After training, we compare the validation performance of a bunch of randomly sampled architectures using generated weights, and then train the best found architecture normally. The HyperNet is fully convolutional, so it can generate weights for networks of arbitrary depth and width, as the size of the output tensor, i.e. the weights, varies with the size of the input to the HyperNet. While the HyperNet never learns to generate weights that are quite as good as if we train them normally, the weights are sufficiently close to optimal that we can plug them in and determine the relative quality of any sampled architectures. So how do we sample architectures beyond varying depth and width? To explore complex connection patterns, I adopt a view of a network as having a series of memory banks it reads and writes, rather than layers that modify a forward propagating signal. In this view, every layer is replaced by an op that reads a subset of memory, changes the data, then writes to another subset. Single branch networks like ResNets overwrite one large memory bank at each layer. Dense nets read from many small banks and write to an empty bank, and other nets have more complex patterns. Sampling an architecture simply consists of setting the size and number of banks, and randomly selecting the read-write config at each layer, along with things like the kernel size and deletion factor of each convolution. So how well does this actually work? To test this, I trained one smash network to completion on CIFAR-100, sampled 50 random architectures, and then compared their performance using HyperNet-generated weights, the smash score, to the true validation performance. While there's clearly some noise, we see a decent correlation that suggests we can indeed use generated weights to compare architectures. With this evidence in hand, I upped the compute budget and the complexity of the search, and tried out Smash on several different benchmarks. As the only cost of evaluation after training is a single pass over a validation set, sampling even hundreds of architectures can be done in a few hours, and the resulting networks attain competitive, though not state-of-the-art performance, on the benchmarks I tested them on. With all that said, there are a number of pitfalls to using this method, some of which I address in the paper, but I hope that this nonetheless represents a strong step towards more efficient meta-modeling. If you'd like to know more, see my paper, check out the code, or feel free to contact me. Thanks for watching.